representative. Small and filth have no place on the street. On the street. No. Small and filth should be.
All clear?
All clear, boss.
Right, this is the plan then. At 10:45, you, Reg, collect me and Ken in the van and take us round to the British Jewellery Centre in the High Street. We arrive outside the British Jewellery Centre at 10:50 AM. I shall then get out of the car, you, Reg, take it and park it back here in Denver Street, right? At 10:51, I shall enter the British Jewellery Centre, where you, Vic, disguised as a customer, will meet me and hand me £5.18 and threepence. At 10:52, I shall approach the counter and purchase a watch costing £5.18 and threepence. I shall then give the watch to you, Vic. You will go straight to Norton's garage here in East Street. You lads come and pick me back up here at 10:56, and we rendezvous in the back room of the car signal at 11:15. All right, any questions?
Well, it don't seem to be doing anything illegal.
What do you mean?
Well, we're paying for the watch.
Yeah?
Well, why are we paying for the watch?
They wouldn't give it to us if we didn't pay for it, would they?
Well, I love this outfit.
Why not?
Well, we never break the bloody law.
What do you mean?
Oh, well, look at that bank job last week.
What was wrong with that?
Oh, well, I think you go in there with a mask on and ask for £15 out of my deposit account.
What are you trying to say, Larry?
Well, couldn't we just steal the watch, boss?
Oh, you dumb cluck! We've spent weeks organising this job. Reg rented a room across the road and filmed people going in and out every day. Vic spent 3 weeks looking at watch catalogues till he knew the price of each one backwards. And now I'm not going to risk the whole raid just for the sake of breaking the law.
Couldn't we park in a double yellow line?
No.
Or could we get a dog to follow the...
No.
Yeah, boss. Oh, what's the matter with you?
I just thought I left the car on a meter and it's...
Overdue?
Yes, boss.
How much?
I don't know, boss. Maybe two... Maybe 5 minutes.
5 minutes overdue? You fool! You fool!
All right, look, no time to lose. Ken, shave all your hair off, get your passport, and meet me at this address in Rio de Janeiro. Can you come down for plastic surgery? Meet me there. Reg, go to Canada. Work your way south to Nicaragua by July. Larry, you stay here as frontman. Give us 15 minutes and blow the building up, all right? Make it fast!
Hey, boss, I can't blow the building up.
Why not?
It's illegal.
Oh, bloody hell. Well, we better give ourselves up then.
We can't, boss.
Why not?
We haven't done anything illegal.
Excuse me.
Oh, no, well, I think being illegal makes it more exciting.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, if you're going to go straight, you might as well be a vicar or something.
If there were fewer robbers, there wouldn't be so many of them, numerically speaking.
Anything sexual ecstasy is overrated.
Well, that's very interesting, because I'm no mead and dull of tin.
After a few more of these remarks, I shall be appearing in a sketch. So stay tuned.
It's the uniform that puts them off. That and my bad breath.
We like dressing up, yes.